Hello, I'm Christoph Hessing, and I'm in charge of technical product management at HUESKER Synthetic. In this videocast, I'm going to explain the reduction factor for considering any damage during the transportation, installation, and compaction of geosynthetics. The design of geosynthetic installations for soil reinforcement involves the use of the characteristic long-term strength value for the relevant material. This characteristic long-term strength is calculated by applying a series of reduction factors to the characteristics short-term strength of the geosynthetic product. The purpose of the reduction factors is to take into account the factors influencing product behavior that are likely to be significant in a particular application. Under the German EBGEO, the recommendations for design and analysis of earth structures using geosynthetic reinforcements issued by the German Geotechnical Society, the reduction factor considering for any damage during the transportation, installation, and compaction of geosynthetics is designated as A2. This is equivalent to the designation RFID, reduction factor for installation damage, used in the international guidelines for the determination of the long-term strength of geosynthetics for soil reinforcement. ISO/TR 2043-2. The possible mechanical damage to geosynthetic reinforcement during installation is determined by means of an installation damage test, which involves comparison of the post-installation tensile strength along with the tensile strength of the undamaged reference material. The detailed procedure for determining installation damage is described in the EBGEO and ISO/TR 2043-2. If no reduction factors exist for directly comparable site conditions, the reduction factors recommended by the manufacturer can be used for preliminary design purposes. However, the performance of an installation test under the effective site conditions is recommended at the start of works in order to verify the applicability of the data to the specific installation conditions on site. This is vital, given that installation damage largely depends on a combination of factors, most notably the selected geosynthetic product, underlying base, type of fill material, layer thickness, compaction equipment, and compaction passes. The post-installation tensile strength determined in this example, where the product is placed in a 0/32 fill, corresponds to 94.5% of the tensile strength of the undamaged material. This is equivalent to a reduction in tensile strength by a factor of 1.06. The A2 reduction factor, or RFID, for installation damage, thus totals 1.06. I hope that this presentation on the reduction factor for installation damage to geosynthetic products has captured your interest. Please let me draw your attention to our videocasts on other reduction factors that need to be applied in calculating the characteristic long-term strength of geosynthetics. Should you wish to know more about the technical details and HUESKER's solutions, then please take a look at our website or contact us directly.